डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एमबीए, विद्यावर्धक कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, मैसूर, कर्नाटका. मैडम हैज कंप्लीटेड इन मैनेजमेंट इन द फाइनेंस स्पेशलाइजेशन इन फाइनेंशियल मार्केट इन द 2016 इन अन्ना यूनिवर्सिटी चेन्नई. इट इज वन अमंग द टॉप 15 यूनिवर्सिटीज इन इंडिया एज पर द एनआईआरएफ रैंकिंग. मैडम इज ऑल्सो द रिकग्नाइज्ड रिसर्च गाइड फॉर द विश्वेश्वर टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी एंड मैडम हैज इवैल्यूएटेड 4 पीएचडी थीसिस एंड गाइडेड मोर देन 17 प्रोजेक्ट्स फॉर एमबीए स्टूडेंट्स. Madam is also the resource person for SEBI and as well as the trainer for the NCFE, that is National Center for Finance Education. Madam has conducted more than 30 workshops in various colleges. Madam has published 20 papers in national as well as international level journals and presented more than 25 papers across in national and international conferences and seminars. Madam has filed a patent on a sustainable leak-proof lunchbox made of aloe vera fiber in August 2020, and Madam has also the patent is granted in the name of Madam for the Green Human Resource Management Practices Framework for Heritage for Healthcare Organization under Stressful COVID-19 on 15 July 2020. And Madam has also developed the Excel template model. And Madam has conducted more than 30 financial education workshops. It is our pleasure to us. Madam has accepted our invitation to conduct the webinar on stock exchange and also on the finance. Thank you, Madam. And I welcome you on behalf of the Chandrasekhar University and the Department of Tourism and Travel. Over to Manjunath.
Thank you, sir. Now may I request today's speaker, Dr. P. Kartika, to start the webinar. Over to you, ma'am.
Before starting the webinar, I would like to thank to all the faculty members and who are supporting for today's webinar. And also I want to tell special thanks to the Rakesh sir, Department of Tourism and Travel from Ashramban University, Kulparki, and it's my hearty thank to every one of you, the supporting there and organizing this webinar, and today provide me opportunity to present myself. Okay, sir, am I audible? It's what about my voice?
Yes, madam, you are audible.
Yes, thank you.
We have assigned you as a presenter, madam. You can share the screen.
So very good morning all. This is Kartika. Today I'm providing this webinar presenting in front of you behalf of Bombay Stock Exchange. So the Bombay Stock Exchange is giving the awareness to the college students and various kind of category of the people to give knowledge about financial literacy. So many of us, we are that means highly educated one. That means I am saying it is even the post graduates we studied, and many people they are in good job, but they are financially illiterate. I'm not telling that. The survey says that in 25% of Indian population only knows about the well financial planning. The remaining 75% of the Indian yet to also get knowledge about this financial planning. So by So make India is empowered one. The country's initiative, so like this regulatories, they are providing the education. That means especially financial education to the public. Why it is needed? You people will ask that. See, that is our money. It is a very very hard earned money. Okay, how it is utilized? How it's well planned to giving a future. To make each and every one of us be financially independent in future time period. So that is the main aim and motto behind this program. So the BSc and initiated that, and my training partner, it is pangadi.go, they are the my training partner. They are supporting for conducting these kind of programs all over the India. Sorry, it's a pan India. So now I just moving to the about today's webinar. the word investment, many students might think about that. Why I should think about? Because I'm not earning anything. So as of now, they are students. But today they are the student, especially the it is postgraduate students and all. The very near, there is very near time. Next year they might be employee in any one of the organization, or they might be an entrepreneur. So they are a start to earn the income. That time they should know that how they can able to wisely invest for their future capital appreciation, or to get financial well-being in the future days. So that is the main aim of this workshop, to giving so it's provided to the college students. So investment, okay, that you might hear about the word, that word might not be new to you, but here I'm just thinking that investment means, okay, try to save in different asset classes which is available in India, and it's regulated by the government. So that is the main aim of this workshop also, because every time in the newspaper we are reading that so and so company, they are promised to give more interest, or they are promised to give the benefit out of the deposit taken from the public, but they closed their business, they went away. So like many, you might know very famous jewel shop in Bangalore city, you might in last year you might heard about the news also. So the people should not go behind that kind of unauthorized, unregulated scheme of savings and investment. That should not happen. That so like that kind of awareness also we are in the position to spread among the educated. So that is also the aim of here. So save the money, hard earned money, in the very small, okay, kinds of asset classes, and that will generate a future return. So I speak, you just think, as even as a student, you just think about that all of your life goals, like one example, we are studying that, okay, our parents will tell in while in the college time, study well, get good score. What is the purpose? Because then only we can get good job. What is the purpose? Then only we can earn. Okay, what is the purpose for earning that? If we earn, they feel that all of our, that means we will able to we are more self oriented, that means self sufficient or independent. We don't depend, and because our earnings are there, we are able to earn, then our standard of life will be increased. But earnings is not a matter. Today there are lot of opportunities people for you, but you have to know if you are earnings also, how you have to properly save it. So all of our life activity, one another, it will be connected to the financial goal. If you are a good financial goalkeeper, you are able to dream, okay, towards your financial goal, definitely you will be self-sufficient. Okay, once your career is started. So that is what today we are going to be see, different asset classes, how it will be help you to make a small amount as an investment. Yeah. So if we don't have any goal, because somebody, you just think about that, when we are joining into your college, somebody guided you take this course, that might be helpful for you. Okay, there are the some person, they are guided us up to this our life to go to select our career. But any one of you, do you have anybody, they are guiding you to invest or save money in the different kind of way? As of now, we don't have any friends like that to say that do this, you will be good at after some point of time. So that kind of guidance we don't have. So how we can get it? By having own knowledge. So that is what we are telling, that there is a definition is there. If not, okay, if there is no goal, how the traveler, so for example, traveler doesn't know where he have to travel. Without destination, he will travel here and there. Finally, what is his energy and the traveling time and the cost what he spent for making reaching the destination? If he doesn't know proper destination, it's a waste like that. So once we start to earn as a student, if you are not knowing that your financial goals properly, absolutely what will happen? So in your career, you won't be happy. So that is what the today's session will be help you. So like you might ask me that, why madam you are speaking about investment, investment, investment? So yes, because you know that this pandemic taught many of us, we recognized the value of the money. Okay, because all of a sudden, if any one of our family members is met, we get positive, we know the value of the money, that means 3 to 5 lakhs they are charging for treating this COVID-19. So that in a save, not only saving, okay, the save, the word is now replaced by the investment. I will tell you what is the difference between the save and investment. The saving is nothing but keeping your money, storing your money. For example, you are storing your money in the cupboard. Can you help it? Yes, it's help whenever necessity, like this kind of pandemic there, that time liquidity is more. You can take it from your cupboard and use the money for the use your, that money for your hospital expenses, or some you want to pay for some utility bills, all this possible. But here our concept is not like that. Money has to generate itself. This means money earns money, money make money. That is a concept of investment. What I'm telling, that means, see, you are today, you are saving that, but it should be accumulated large value for in your future. So that we are calling as an investment. Okay. So why we have to do investment? Because if you store your money at home, your money value will reduce because of the inflation. So you might ask me that, what is the inflation? Inflation means the goods and service values are keep on increasing except your money value. For example, today the 500 rupees sufficient for you to go to and be and come back. For example, the minimum, it's, I know that this value is very less, but the same 500 rupees after 2 years, not sufficient. You might need 1,000 rupees to go to movie and come back. Okay. That is what the goods and services available is keep on increasing that. So is it increasing at home? Automatically, what will happen? There is no interest for that. Okay, the money, the capital using. Today, the 500 rupees worth, you keep it at home. So next year, the worth of the 500 rupees may be 400 rupees. 100 rupees is reduced because of the inflation. Want to beat the inflation? You have to select a product and you have to invest. Next one. So our life, we can't generate the income entire period. For example, after 25 years, you might spend for education. Then next 35 years, this income generated period, you will earn to, you are able to earn, you are able to save money for the next, okay, next 15 years, because all of us, we have retired at the age of 60. Okay, what will happen after that? After the 60 years, we are not able to generate income, but expenses are more than that period. So we have to save the money for a retirement period. No. Unplanned expenses, as I told, the medical expenses is the very, very horrible. Okay, we have to bear that. Next one, luxury bending. That means why the word I put luxury bending means even there is an economics theory will be there, price and income level. Okay, if it is income level increase, that time what have to demand will increase, because the people, the income level increasing, they are trying. But this luxury bending is its opposite to that. For example, I planning of buying a car in your life, constructing the house. So like need, it is buying a car, it's not an easy job. Okay, unless you are not planned 15 years before that. Okay, that means the very small amount you are trying to save, after 15 years you are trying to buy a car or construct a house, that is a easy to able to achieve. So though you have your income is increased or not, but these kind of needs is there in the life. Always once a life, they need a good house, they need a good car. This is all minimum. Now it is everybody's expectation. So that you have to plan your investment well in advance. So all of this, okay, we are necessitated to invest. Yeah. So there is a mantra is there for investment. Whether I'm getting 20,000 as a salary, my salary might be a 1 lakh. So however I'm earning, so today as I told, the earnings is not a matter. How much I'm earning, that won't protect me in your future. Who is production provider for my future? My savings only. So there is a mantra. Everyone, they have to save 20 to 30% of their salary. Okay, everyone, they have to save 20 to 30% of their monthly income. Okay, who may be salaried or it is a self-employed or some any income, their income earning capacity, 20 to 30% they have to save. And otherwise, they can't be happy their future stage of the life, okay? So 20 to 30% savings is the necessary one. Like, how savings will be possible? How savings will be possible? Today, the environment surrounded to you make expenses only, okay? Today, the environment is surrounded to you, it's a make expenses only. Because that kind of marketing strategy, its marketing strategy is going on. Look at the credit card, I tell you best example. We are not able to control our expenses because somebody is given loan to us. This means my card has a limit. So I'm just doing, whenever I'm going to the shopping, I never counted the expenses because I have a card limit I used. I have the salary, like it is a 1 lakh, the people that they are getting. So the uncontrollable expenses, they are not limiting the expenses because of the environment like that, because the marketing people are like that, attracting advertisement. So finally, where we are landing, do you know that? Upper savings are reducing because of the expenses that too, because in your father and mother, their lifestyle is different. Their way of budgeting is different. Why I'm telling you, cash economy. You might now you can know the difference between the cash economy, cashless economy. That too, India is planning about digital India. That means all the transaction taken place in after 5 years only in online mode. There is no cash transaction. That would be going to happen in India. So what is the impact? Why we should scared about that? There are the positive and negative. Both aspects will be there. So what is the negative aspects? We don't know the money value because that physically association with the cash, it won't be there. Why? It means, see, if I'm just going to the one shopping mall, I have in my packet only 2,000 rupees, what I do? I spend only 2,000 rupees because I have only. If I'm going the same shop with my credit card, what I do? I have card limit of 50,000, even I'm middle class. So that time what I do? At least bother about even that particular product is 2000, 2500 because I have card limit. Yeah, I'm just spend the money and who's going to repay? I have to repay it automatically. What is the impact for me? I'm not able to go this portion savings and investment because my expenditure is high. So as a college student, please think about that. Even a monthly 500 rupees spending for unwanted things, better stop it. Do you know that? I will tell you one example in the end of the class. If you do monthly 500 rupees savings, how much it will be accumulated future, how it will be benefited, okay? Look at that. It is even a single 10 rupees you are spending that, you have to think whether you are spending that amount for necessities or it's for luxury. The luxury things I want to tell you, it's not affordable for the based upon our financial status. That means our, I want to tell you, your family. So the especially the students, they won't understand that financial stability or financial stage because your classmate has or someone has, you want maybe bike or some branded mobiles, which is higher and costly for your, as per your financial standard. But you don't not at all think about that. Blindly for the EMI Because now that is what I'm told. It is that economic, that environment is like that. You just pay one initial amount, you will take that maybe a bike or maybe the costly mobile for paying EMI. Better think about that. If there are the some alternative product is there, please think and try to buy that. That is the best way, because until unless expenses is reduced, either you have the income of 1 lakh or 20,000, it doesn't matter. Okay, if you are not saving that, you are not reducing that, the future is, it's a painful for every one of us. So the my thing has an advice is reduce expenditure. Even you are able to, how much is need, you buy it. Is it a necessary item? Buy. See, every time you can classify your expenses, need versus desire. If anything buying your need category, buy. If you are buying anything is desire category, don't buy it. It is called this impulse buying, unwantedly, because of offer, because of they can year end clearance sale, or they will give and deal of the day. All this is a magic word. It's attract the people and catch hold. These are all the marketing strategy. So, because what will the use of that, buying the electronic item of unwantedly, I'm telling that, okay? So once you can open your cupboard, you might look at that, there's so many clothes are lying down. Do you know that? It is, you might, the very famous personality, Sudha Murthy, her interviews, she told that past 30 years, she didn't take even a single dress for her. That, see? It says that she is like doesn't have. It says that doesn't have any. Not like that. She don't want to spend unwantedly because already there. So that is what I'm telling. In each and every time, report spending it. Check whether you are spending for your need. It means it's something useful to your life. It's something which will be very helpful for your day-to-day activity. Buy it. If you are buying for any desire, like it is for festival, you have to celebrate the festival unwantedly if you take one more edition of the class. It's not necessary. Don't do that. Yeah. So next one, I'm just speaking about financial planning. Okay. So what is financial plan? Everyone has to have the financial goal. So what is a financial goal? You just think about buying of a car, buying up a home, or you want to set a business. Okay, so what it is mean that after 5 years I need 5 lakh rupees. That is my financial goal. What is 5 lakh rupees? I want to start small business. So my plan is that. So how I'm this 5 lakh rupee is generated by me? So what kind of investment asset classes is available to me? So how I'm able to generate this 5 lakh rupees? That is your financial plan. So each, because if you are not clear about that, you don't have the future commit, future goal, automatically what will happen, that means, as I told, no, the traveler without destination plan, they can roam wherever they want like that. If I don't have any financial boundary, financial commitment, what I do, all my salary I spend as it is, like, okay. But if I have this financial goal, so what I do, I am save, I am try to invest for that, okay. For this, you can might invest into the mutual fund, or you might open an RD account. You can save considerable amount, or you can put fixed deposit. So many options are available. So based upon the risk profile, you can select any one of the investment avenues, that is asset classes. Try to reach your at 5 lakh rupees. It's a financial goal down the line. It's a 5 years. So that is a smart financial plan. Why the smart financial plan? See, you know, Abdul Kalam has asked you to dream it. I am telling you, dream it in financial way. Dream it in the financial term. That means you are planning to save something, or you want to achieve financial target after 5 years, after 10 years, after 15 years. Put the goals like that. Plan to go run the goals towards up to your 60 years. After that, enjoy your... Okay, after that, enjoy your life. The next one. So So the financial plan is different for everyone. We cannot have the common financial plan because based upon our age, based upon our income level, the financial plan is customized. It is a tailor move. So every one of the need. Yeah. So in your home, you might look good about that, your mom and done it in, okay, that is expenditure, income and expenditure, everyone, okay, if you are student also, you just calculate it, your income and expenditure, how many, that means income in the, maybe in the form of you are getting from your father or maybe somebody will might do a part-time job also, and you can check out what are the expenditure you are making that and manage your cash flows. So what is today's you need and what you have to do in tomorrow's responsibility, then you will definitely reduce your expenditure, build wealth, okay? So earnings, again, I am telling that build wealth. So earnings are making money. It is not equivalent to the building capital. So that means what I'm saying that no. So build wealth, how you can able to build wealth? It's a disciplined way, regular practices. Disciplined way in this and nothing but monthly you can able to save 500 rupees for the students community. Do it for next 15 years and see that how much you are able to it's if it is you are putting into monthly 500 rupees in the mutual fund. Let check you how much amount is accumulated after the 15 years. Okay, that is called it's a building wealth. Next, identify the investment opportunities. Identifying the investment opportunities is nothing but it's what is your financial situation, okay? So allocate the money among the different asset classes like fixed deposit, RD, post office deposit, mutual fund, equities, gold, all like whichever the suitable for you, do it. And this will you give you a good standard of living after a certain period. And I want to tell you that every people, they have to protect their family, okay? They have to protect their family financially after one's loss also. That means if any one of the earning person in the family, they might lose their life, the other should not suffer because of that. How it should be done? It should be done through due to insurance. So insurance also, it is very, very mandatory to every one of us because we are losing our loved ones. Not only that, financially, the family also, it's a suffer lot if the earning members of the family is dismissed. So that should not happen. So planning properly about insurance also, it is one of the individual need. Okay, so as I told, I'm dreaming like I need so many lakhs after after some years of period. If that how the dream will come true if I do, okay, investment. Then, so you might ask me that, so you are speaking, madam, investment, and what are the different asset classes are available? Yeah, so before I'm going to the different type of asset classes available to guy, so what should not do, okay? Even though you are not investing, better I'm say, okay, fine, but don't invest in these class of asset classes and very, very bad. See, the first one I will go for the Ponzi scheme. The Ponzi scheme is nothing but fraud scheme. Especially they will promise you to give more return. For example, if you deposit 1 lakh rupees, they promise you monthly giving 8,000 rupees as interest. They ask you to deposit minimum amount like 20,000. They might give you monthly, okay, it's monthly 1,500 rupees as a interest. Do you think that for 20,000, 1,500 rupees, this interest is able to receive It is not at all possible. None of the bank, none of the government approved schemes are providing that. But these kind of third parties, they will promise and collect the money from the public by promising giving back highest return. That not at all possible. So many examples we will quote for the Ponzi schemes. You might know every time newspaper, you might read that chip and company, this gold company or that the scheme, land scheme, real estate scheme, they collected deposit from the public. See, especially I tell you that except bank and few NBFCs and post office, these are all the regulated entity to collect the deposit from the public. They have to get permission from the RBI. Until unless none of the private and third party people not eligible for collecting the money, okay, deposit is in the form of deposit. So please, you should be on chit funds. Also, see, there are the thing, chit funds, I think you might know that the group of people joined together, they will contribute a small amount, the total amount will be given. I'm not telling that it's completely, there are the government regulated chit funds are there, they are registered under the government, they are doing the business, that's fine. But many new strange people, it is unknown people, they are coming to your places and doing these kind of business. Better don't invest the money under this. And the self-employment yojana, they will, that means actually that will be there in the government, but the people are privately what they are doing, the self-employment yojana, they will say join this committee, we are creating the self-employment yojana, so they ask you to contribute one portion of money, so the collective money will be utilized for giving arranging interviews are like that. Don't give the money for all these kind of things. And these are all network marketing, okay, or that is means all these things means especially for the students community, they will brainwash it. You might join one person or you refer one person, you can get the cash, or you act as a distributor. If you join 4 or 5 people under you, you will get regular income. All this kind of marketing, okay, MLM, network marketing, multi-level marketing schemes, don't, as a student community, don't put your leg into these kind of marketing. It's everything, it's for the temporary purpose. They will be the chain will be locked in at one side, you won't get it benefited from these kind of this thing. See, you are not able to invest your money into the government regulated scheme. At least keep it with you safely, don't go behind these kind of things by crazy or just like greedy about getting the highest interest, please. And also as a students, you won't do, I hope it, but might in your locality, some third parties will come and market in each city, collect the deposit from the people and go away. Please giving the spread the knowledge about all those things. If any one of your known person community are involving these kind of things, better advise them. It's not a right way for doing. Next one. Yeah, principles of wise investment. Okay, the principles of wise investment means especially the people should do for longer time, small amount of money, keep on invest for longer time. Okay, that is a wise investment. Next one, it's diverse your portfolio. So like how I'm eating the lunch, you know, the menu card of the lunch. So it is all varieties is there. Okay. You should not eat single food, like means it's like rice, you know, curd, all that is curry or something in your menu. It's like your plate of the lunch. It's colorful and different variety. Same thing, investment also, even you are doing 500 rupees in one asset classes, you can do 500 rupees, like 500 rupees FD, 500 rupees in mutual fund, 500 rupees in a gold scheme. So all this to be like that, it is not a single, you should not invest or make money into the single portfolio. Next one, okay, do not be greedy. You should not be greedy. If you greedy, definitely you will be failure in your achievements, because do you know, when you be greedy, because you are so psychologically behind that rate of return, or like And the people, especially in the stock market, what the people will do, know, they can't bear that pain of loss. Again, they will borrow the money, again keep on trade it. Again, that somehow they are emotionally in, okay, they are bounded with that kind of activity. Do not do that. Don't invest with the borrowed money. Okay, don't invest with the borrowed money. That is my request. Okay, yeah, invest regularly, start early. Do you know that invest regularly, start early? Okay, I want to tell the word, the one example, start early. Okay, I just yeah. Have you seen yeah, this picture denotes Warren Buffett. Ma'am, this slide is visible because I'm changing the slide from one PPT to another one. Okay, I'm just a displayed.
It is visible, ma'am.
Yeah, Warren Buffett is visible, ma'am. Okay, yes. Yeah. So this, you might see that it's a Warren Buffett photo. So you just look at that. He started to invest at the age of 11 years. Okay, so the people will not understand that why for this college student, this investment class, because early age, do invest and start to try to invest into the early age. I'm not telling to do a directly investment to the stock market. There are the product for the your age group of people. That is the best way to save the money for a longer period. Okay. Yeah, so the man, you know that this, when it is the one of the interview, the question is asked for the Warren Buffett, he quoted it seems. So he started investing from the age of 11 onwards, it seems. But he told that his opinion was he was wasted until his age of 11 without doing investment in the market. So that much of patient towards the what he's doing. So I think almost the college students, means your age is 20 years. Okay, you are the right person to address and provide the knowledge regarding investment. Okay, so just I put a look at that. There is a one calculation regarding small. If you have this, see this concept will give you how now it's a believing only savings bank account or keeping money into your savings bank account is the one that many people will think that is the only the big way or major way to make an investment, especially my father and mom also feels that, yeah, it's their generation, they feels that this is the only way to make an investment. But nowadays you see that what are the pitfalls are there. For example, you have put your account has 1 lakh rupees. Okay, that interest rate, that means for the savings account now it is a 4% only interest rate, it is a 4000, and this is not applicable. Okay, so tax on interest, leave it is not applicable. There is a DDS will be there, that is a 7%. Okay, leave it. So that 4% after the 1 year, your money value will be 1 lakh 4000. Now the inflation is 5%. So as of now, the average inflation rate is 5% to 6%. You look at that, inflation is 5%, and what will be your end of the value 1 year after the period? Money value 90,000. That 1 lakh 4000 minus 1000, your value is 99,000. So what it is says, so though you are depositing 1 lakh rupees in your current account, so your savings account has 1 lakh rupees, the bank is provide 4% inflation, so 4% interest, but inflation of the country is 5%. Your money value is reduced even though it is in your SB account. So that is what it means. So whatever the asset classes you are choosing, that that provide a return more than that inflation rate of the country, then only your money value is increasing, otherwise your money value is perishing. So you should think about all these aspects. It's as of now, it is a government national pension scheme. It is a government supported scheme. It's giving more than 10. So it is more than 9%. As of now, the NPS is 10%. Still, the inspection of the scheme, the return is 10%. You might look at that. If you are keep on regularly investing, you are starting at 25. You are doing up, okay? It's till the age of 60. Think that how much your contribution, how much it's accumulated value. Your contribution is 4,20,000, but the but it is the interest accumulated value is 23,09,000. Look at that. Please look at that. What is the major difference? Is see, you are starting at the very early age. Okay, do it for the longer period. So automatically your accumulated value is more than if you start the same amount at the age of 40. So how much it's in? See the difference of your savings and the accumulated value. So this is for just, it is an eye-opening session for you. So why this much, okay, it is necessary for the college students, means even a small amount, okay, do it an early age, the accumulated value will be a large. So I will put in another slide. I can share with you that one more example also. Okay, so look at that here. Just now you understand the concept. I just practically tell you where you have to do and how you can do that. I can tell you that. See, for example, same thing. If it is a 15% of rate of return, you might think that which investment asset classes will give you 15% of it is a realistic one only. Why I'm saying 15% of return also, it's a realistic means. See that if it is a, you are just look at the value, you are start to invest 1,000 rupees, okay, until your 60 age. So total value for 15% of 15% of return will be there. It's going more than 1 crore. It's going more than 1 crore. But if you do it in a later age, okay, you want to do like of savings or investment in the age of 40, that time it's ended with 15 lakhs. So the thing is, what you have to take about, I'm not make you too greedy. I want to realize you do it anything an early age, even you are trying to save small amount, that will be giving a larger in a longer period. That means you are starting to invest into the small age. So that is my point of view here. See why I told it is 15%, okay, it is 15% rate of return. Is it possible? You look at the graph of capital market return from 2003 to 2018, or now also, it's not down the line, its average return is, it's a 17%, okay, compounded and annual growth rate. So compounded annual growth rate, it says that 17% of the BSE return. If you take a Nifty also, it's a NSE also, you can see the return, the trend is always up. It's market is providing that. And so the thing is, I'm not to make you to fix in your mind 15% return will be there. Yes, there are the product, the 15% of return also there. So if you anything you start in a very in a right now, you are continuously doing for it is a more than 10 years, all just kind of product, maybe mutual fund, okay, or national pension scheme or Atal pension scheme, all will give you good accumulated value in over the longer period. So that is my concept here. So it's not too late. It is that today I'm just addressing to the right audience. It's a college student. So the first one. So just before going to the save, because save all kind of first product ourselves. The product ourselves is nothing. Product ourselves is nothing but okay. You just think about the insurance. So this pandemic thought and scared about ourselves to go behind this kind of insurance. Okay, so there are two major classification of that insurance: term insurance and the health insurance. See, The term insurance under there are the classification is there. I just tell you that this product, yeah. So now I'm speaking about insurance. If the health insurance is nothing but your medical bills, either reimbursed or you can get it a cashless treatment. That we can call health insurance. So if it is, you have the any kind of private insurance scheme, okay, that means you have took Mediclaim policies from the insurance company, you can get a cashless treatment, okay. So now, so many people, they started to take insurance for covering the cost of the COVID-19 that is happening now. Term insurance. The term insurance is nothing but if something happened to the policy holder within the particular term, then the insurance amount will go to the policy holder. So let me see the example for this, then we move to the next asset classes. Sir, is my screen is visible?
Yes, madam, it is visible.
Yeah. See, as of now, we don't have the awareness about the insurance. Why I'm telling no? So because of how we are selecting the insurance product. If some market agents are coming and telling to us, or somebody is, the neighbors, or some relatives are telling that they took the policy. So we are also going behind and taking the insurance policy, especially that it's a wrong sales. We should not do like that. And then how we have to do that? So I have to list out my risk. So I have to list out my risk. As I told, one is your hospital bills, okay, your hospital expenditures that to be reimbursed. So you have to go for Mediclaim policy, or you want to get a cashless treatment. You feel about your health condition is more your conscious. So you feel that it's a medical, the hospital bills for you for getting a treatment is more. So you are planning about taking the medical insurance. Okay. So that is your list of the second one. Early age, because of some diseases like heart attack, or like that we are seeing that it's a heredity page, heredity also, maybe father is died like that, there are the chances to son also go like that. It is like I'm saying that the opinion about the people, that is not 100% is true also, but the people will, they want to protect life, so they can go term insurance plan like that. Or some people, they want savings plus production. That means if something happened within that particular period, that for the beneficiary, they can get it the policy amount. If the people will live after the term also, they have to get some saved amount back. That is called, it is a savings plus production. So we will classify our risk, whether my hospital expenses. So that time I go Mediclaim policy. Only my, if I'm just taking term insurance plan, if I die, if my family will get 50 lakhs rupees, 1 crore rupees, that is called term insurance. So for that, you pay less premium. Only death happen, family member will be get benefited. That is term insurance policy. No. So the person is died within the particular period of term, okay. They will get benefit, or surviving after the policy period, some policy amount is returned to that, policy value is returned to that, that we can call it is a endowment. So it is based for the endowment, premium is high because both the cases they will get benefited. For the term insurance, premium is low because they only get benefit once if death is happened. So these are all the different type of insurance policies are there. Not only this, there are the so many types are there. Okay. It's ELSS will be there, and money back, especially I'm telling money back policy. That means once in a 5th year, 10th year, 15th year, some money will be returned to the policy holder. So these are the different class of insurance. So check your profile risk. What type of risk you have? Based upon that, select the policy. You have to tell your parents and you have to plan because this is the right age. So I just want to tell few of the government example also here. One is medical policy. See, as I told, no, for health insurance, every one of us in our packet there is a one medical policy should be there. See, plan it in a right age. That means if you crossed 40 years, the premium what you have to pay for the medical policy for getting a cashless treatment is very, very costly. So if the you are taking for the so which person age is highest, that is only the they can consider for fixing the premium. So the three people planning to take a medical claim policy, you are the one, any one that is eldest member, that is a 35 years, means they take only 35 years for calculating the premium. Based upon the age, okay, the premium value what you are paying, that will fluctuate. If the small age, the premium is less. The age is high, the premium is high. So please take the medical claim policy. If you are planning, plan it before 40 years of you and your family members. Look at that. So it's monthly 1,000 rupees the premium for getting the cashless treatment, up to 5 lakh rupees for your family members. So this will be, so how many hospitals are in lakh? So like that, you can compare the product from one insurance company to and another insurance company and take, okay, good medical claim policy for you, because it's a mandatory in the pandemic for every one of us. Next one, few people might not able to affordable for the Ayushman Bharat Yojana scheme available. This is for the poor people who are not able to afford for the other private insurance. So the COVID-19 treatment also covered under this Ayushman Bharat Yojana in India. 20,000 hospitals are empaneled with that. For that, what you have to do, just log into this website and generate the card, e-card for the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. That is my humble request. Next one. See, this is also I want to tell you another government insurance scheme that will be available for every one of us. We should enable this policy from our bank account, that is Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. That will be for, it is only 12 rupees, the 2 lakh accidental insurance policy given by the government. Next, life insurance. Okay, if you, the people are die, then that time they can get the insurance claim under this Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana. This we can call 300 rupees insurance, that is a premium value per annum. So what I told, 12 rupees, that is also per annum, 330 rupees per also annum. But life insurance is, this coverage is 2 lakh rupees. For 330 rupees, 2 lakh coverage is the very big amount. It's supported by the government. You don't go to any private insurance companies to enable this. Wherever you have SB account, which bank you have SB account, there only you can enable this facility. It is a best for all of us. Next one. See, I want to tell some free insurance. Complimentary insurance are available for the credit cards and the debit card. I hope today every one of us, we are using the debit card. Not many of us, even though we are not in the position to use a credit card, debit card. For debit card also, Visa card insurance is different, RuPay card insurance is different. Please log in into the your which card you are using, which company card using, RuPay card or Visa card. Please tell, know yourself what is the complimentary free insurance is available with the particular card. Because I want to tell you the practical example. One of us, like trainer, he passed away due to the accidental insurance, the road accident. His family members claimed 6 lakh rupees only of this kind of insurance. 2 lakh from that accidental insurance, what I told, the 12 rupees, and 2 lakhs from the life insurance, that is the 330 rupees plan, and he used a RuPay card. Totally 6 lakh, okay, will claimed the family members. Okay, these and all the free insurance schemes are available, and credit card holders, there are the free insurance, plenty of free insurance. Please log into the bank website, check what are the different free insurance are available, because the people without awareness, if the necessities are not in the position to use this kind of product, so that I want to enlighten that. Next one, the mutual funds, SIBs. And the people who are doing mutual fund regularly, SIBs, like monthly, they are doing investment. Okay, 500 rupees they are doing in the mutual fund. For them, there is a pre-complimentary insurance are available. So please check with the which company's mutual fund. Okay, log in the particular website and check it out. Next one, the government has opened the free account, that is called Chandan account. For that also, there is a free insurance will be available. If any one of your member or known community, they are working using this Chandan account, let tell them they have the free accidental coverage of insurance and as well as a life insurance coverage of 30,000. Yeah. Yeah, just I want to tell you, for a students, okay, this National Pension Scheme, NPS, it's useful for everyone, whether we are working under the organized sector, the BF account will be there or not there for protecting your future, National Pension Scheme is need. Please try to put, I'm just look giving the insight, your age and your family commitment and how you are able to save for your future. So look at this calculation, your age is now 25. I might, after 1 or 2 years you join the job, that's this age group you might reach 25 years. So you thought of making retirement at the age of 55 years, okay? So you are planning to save 30 years monthly. I'm just speaking about monthly. If you do small amount, 2000 rupees monthly out of your salary, future salary, okay? As of now, okay, the scheme is giving 10% rate of return from the inspection of the scheme. But I just put it low, return only 9%. Do you know how much that accumulated amount? Cumulated amount is 36 lakhs. Cumulated amount is 36 lakhs. How much your contribution? 7 lakh. How much it is the capital generated? Interest income is generated, 29 lakhs. Look at that. You are saving 7 lakhs, but 29 lakhs is the interest income. It is not a huge amount. Yes, it is a huge amount. How could it be possible? This is possible because you are saving into the small age, saving for the longer period, so the interest income is high. Look at, this is a government guaranteed scheme, National Pension Scheme. All the banks, you are, this kind of NPS is available. Okay, so might you just to tell to your parents if you are do this, if you are not in the position to it. So after this, whether you want to reinvest, you can reinvest this amount, take 1%, like it is 80% you are reinvesting at. So the remaining 20% that time you take it for your own purpose. So out of this generated in future, you reinvest the 29 lakhs. Okay. Then what will every month in the olden age, you around 25,000, you are able to get it as a pension from this plan. Otherwise, you want to use this 36 lakhs in the future for some other purpose, building construction, then you can generate a rental income. So as I told, financial goal is important for every one of you. Until unless you have financial goal, you don't have the regular, that is like a systematic way of investing into the small amount, longer period, we can't be happy at a retirement age. Okay, next, for especially for the college students, I want to tell you Atal Pension Yojana, okay, that is very small amount. Look at, I hope you are at the age of 20. Suppose you invest monthly 248. Do you know that how much you can able to get it a monthly pension after your retirement? That is means after your retirement, 5,000 rupees. See, you are not, you are doing for only 20 years. You starting at 20, you stopped at 40 years, at the age of 40. Monthly 250 rupees. It's like a, what we can call, it's like a recharge amount for your mobile phone. But you can get it a monthly pension is like a 5,000 rupees at the age of your retirement. If the person is not available, definitely who will that? The beneficiary will get 8.5 lakh as a benefit, okay, to the family. It's a benefit to the family members. So you are doing small amount, but it is a big one. Yeah. So before going to the mutual fund, I just... Yeah. Yes. So fixed income investment. Next one. I just finished term insurance. I covered different term insurance, NPS and APS I covered. Now I'm moving to the fixed income. So you might ask me, whatever the fixed income? Doing FD in the fixed income securities? If you are open public provident account, okay, national savings certificate, which is available in the post office, okay, Kisan Vikas Patra available in post office, National Certificates of Deposit, FD, these all will give a fixed income investment. So fixed income means the return is in fixed. So now it is, this is a current situation because of pandemic, the rate, it's not 8%, okay, it will be reduced, okay, interest rate is reduced, but that will be revised. I hope that will be revised. So some small amount, monthly 500 rupees, do in a PF account, monthly 500 rupees, do as a savings under the Kisan Vikas Patra. Like a small amount you can save in these kind of fixed income securities, fixed income options. So for the longer period, that small considerable portion will be give assurance for this return also, and your principal amount also sure. So doing that, you can do it in a post office or you can do it in the banks. Yeah, next one is equity income, equity investment. Yeah, this is the best investment, but it is a highly risky. But if you are doing for a longer period, small amount of investment, then definitely you will be getting a good idea about that. See, I want to tell one, last year when I was discussing the paper in my class, at that time it's you might know that Indian Railway, okay, IRCTC. That time IPO is opened, that is Railway, Indian Railway started to issue the new shares. Do you know that the shares are around, it's available for 325 to 330 rupees. That is the price it's available for the new issue. But after the 15 days, it came into the trading, double the price, 600 plus. I'm speaking about October 2019. Do you know that market price of the IPO, the market price of Indian Railway, now it is trading, okay, 1600 plus rupees, 1600 plus it's a per share. See, it's given more than 300% return. How much more than 300% return? Return is 300%. We are fighting 5% expected return. We are fighting with 10% of return with some other schemes. But it is given 300%. I will tell lot of examples. You can be bros, RL. You can invest 3 lakhs in the year 2017 in the Reliance Industries. Now that is, you can get it more than 14 lakhs. So many examples we can quote it, but actually it is not easy. It is not very easy to pick the company. We will easily select our life partner, but selecting the best company, invest into that company shares, it's a very, very, very difficult. It's a highly risky. I'm not saying it is not possible. Possible, when you possible, read all the magazines, okay? Read the news regarding the market. Invest 100 rupees in the shares, study and learn the market. After longer period, try to invest a small amount and try get a knowledge, then you can buy it. Be a long-term investor, definitely you can able to get it. See, none of the instrument will give this kind of return. But I want to tell one other real-time stories. It's my professor. Actually, when I was in UG, my professor, okay, he got the shares once his son was born. Okay, he done that, it is for 1987, okay, but 5 years back, his accumulated wealth is 75 lakhs over the investment he made 20,000 in 1987. This is a real story I'm telling about my professor. And he's out of his accumulated amount, he got a medical seat for his son. That and all, it's happened. Many examples also there. Many examples are also happened in the negative side also. We can see so many people are lost out of their stock market investment. All plus and minus are there. But the thing is, I'm telling that read more magazines. Try to know how to pick the company and do it a small amount for a longer time. Definitely it's good. You can get it a good rate of return over that. Then I am coming to the next one. Yes, mutual fund. Many people, we feel that, okay, market, stock market is it's very, very risky, then it is a good avenue for you is mutual fund. You can enjoy a good over rate of return. It's near to the equity market, okay, equity investment, but you can do indirectly stock investment through mutual fund. So mutual, I will tell you the different type of mutual funds are available based upon the risk profile. If I want to take a risk, I will invest into the equity oriented mutual fund. Wait, I just open one example for the mutual fund. Yeah, if I want to take high risk, I will go and invest stock oriented mutual fund. If I want to, I don't want to take risk, I just want less rate of return, but my principal amount must be safe, I will go with the bond oriented. If I want to moderate, I can go for gold and real estate. So here, what is the mutual fund concept? Instead of I'm directly invest into these asset classes, I will enjoy the return which is equal to this kind of category of the investment, but I'm indirectly doing the mutual fund, because under the mutual fund concept, you are not directly invested. You are giving your money to the fund manager. They pull investor like us from various part of one geographical area, then that amount will be invested into the various asset classes. We can get a return over that. So that is the best way. So one example for the students community, if you invest monthly 500 rupees in any one scheme, either ELSS through systematic investment plan, that is a monthly you are saving every month 500 rupees. So what could be the return? So this is a one calculation I made for you. You are doing as a student monthly 500 rupees in a mutual fund, equity mutual fund. So you are doing for this 10 years. I just put expected return is 16%. You are saving 60,000, but return generated, interest is generated over your investment is 88. Your total value is 1,48,000. See, look at that, 1,48,000. You are saved amount is 60,000. You are getting more than double the debt within a 10 years of period. Every month you are doing only 500 rupees, the very small amount. So every one of us, we are able to have the capacity of saving 500 rupees. But frankly speaking, we don't do it because we don't know where to go and how to invest this 500 rupees. So that is what I'm telling. Do it in a mutual fund. Do it in a mutual fund. Monthly 500 rupees. Do it for 5+ years. Definitely the rate of return, it's double than that bank return. Okay. Yeah. So suppose somebody will do it as a 10,000, it is like 1,000 is monthly. Okay, definitely look at that. Yeah, sorry. So yeah, 1,000 rupees in a month, they can do in a mutual fund in the monthly basis. Monthly basis, they can do for 1,000 rupees. Or see, look that, for I just reduced again rate of return, they can able to generate 5 lakh rupees in the year of 15 years. So the small amount will be accumulated as a large value in the over the period of time. Yes. So next, I just want to advantages. Why the mutual fund is advantages? Because there are some fund managers are there. We are not directly investing into the scheme. Our fund is professionally managed by the mutual fund company. So there are the some schemes, they are providing the tax benefit also. So that is a good for the advantages. So the systematic investment plan, that means every month you keep on investing into that. Okay, that is called small investment. Every month you are investing into the mutual fund, that will be give greater benefit to the longer period. So there are the schemes, once that is its systematic withdrawal plan, it's like a pension scheme. Every month if you want, you are doing the systematic investment plan SIP for 20 years. So that means that is your income period. After that, you want to considerable amount for every month. You want 10,000. You want to every month you want to withdraw from your saved, that is invested amount, that qualifies as a systematic withdrawal plan. It's look like it's a pension scheme only. That is also will be possible here. So next, see, the goal is, you, as I told, that you go to a goal which you want. So if capital preservation, to whom age 50 plus people, they feel they won't want to take a risk, the invested amount should feel safe, so they can go do these kind of asset classes. If capital appreciation is 25 or 20 plus or 20 years, these kind of people, these kind of investments, so they have the lifespan, so they can able to good. So the medium, okay, the people don't want to take medium risk, they can go these kind of asset classes, so that will give, generate very regular income to them. So it's, see, financial goal, investment goal, myself and yours, definitely it won't match based upon your age, based upon your income generation capacity, based upon your liability. Already, whatever the liability you have, you can decide which is a suitable things for you. Okay, decide your portfolio and do the investment. But as I told, that as of now, I explained, definitely one Mediclaim policy, one term insurance policy, one NPS, one APS, and the government is given for the 12 rupees and 330 rupees. These are all the mandatory, and one SIB, systematic investment plan under the mutual fund, even a 500 rupees, please you do it. So all this is a process. I don't want to go depth about that, because nothing, you just call your banker and check about, okay, check about the things. Okay, so this is my training partner. Okay, it's Hamra just Josie. I want to thank them personally, providing me this opportunity and giving me that to enrich the knowledge to the college student in terms of investment. So finally, that my request is that, so don't feel it is you are doing a small amount or a big amount. So the what amount is you are planning to invest, that is not a condition, but you have to plan how much you are investing every month and where you are investing. So in my session, I just putting a summary, okay, important, and I just, yes, NPS, it's everyone you are able to do. Then mutual funds, I told only 500 rupees, APS, Atal's pension scheme, then, okay, basic insurance. As I told, that is even though it is a government, and as well as if it is possible, you can plan for your Mediclaim policies. These are under the minimum and considerable expend money into your FD account, because for managing the emergency. So these are all the basic need for every one of us. We should hold and with us to be happy financially. So this session is done by Dr. Karthika. If you have any doubt, okay, in future, if you are selecting any product in your, okay, you need any assistant or anything, you might contact, text me or mail me anytime. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam, for your valuable information regarding the investment. Now we'll begin with the interactive sessions, and that will be handled by Mr. Professor Rakesh Mali Patil, and the vote of thanks will be done with the same. Over to Rakesh.
Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. So now let us begin the Q&A session. So any questions, you can post in the chat box, or you can directly ask, raise the question for the resource person. There is a question from Saina in the chat box. Madam, there is a question from
Okay, sir,
Sainath.
please. Yes, sir, please. Go ahead.
Yeah. Why are people of India afraid to invest in anything? Is it because lack of knowledge or risk involved in this?
Sir, especially I'm telling you, it is the survey says that it is a lack of knowledge, sir. See, if people, other than believing the system, what they are circulating locally more. So that is happening now. There are the, see, I'm not saying that they don't have the money for investing. They are having the money. But what is happening now? They are doing in a, their known base, because awareness is not there. Especially Frankly speaks about only 2% of the Indian community known about how to do investment in the mutual fund. You might, that is, one is witnessed the advertisements now, it is given through IPL session also. So that much of advertisement is going here. That is my perception, sir.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Any other questions from the participants? Any other questions from the participants? You can post in the chat box, or you can directly unmute your mic and you can raise the question in the forum. A question. May we have the questions from the participants?
Yeah, there is another question from Rakesh Kumar. Yes, can I address sir, Rakesh sir?
Yes, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
DMAT account, yeah, Zerodha is one of the trade, okay, it's a share broker, Zerodha account. So usually the DMAT account will help you to purchase the shares. Not only the shares, if the what are the securities are available in the market, share market. Maybe it's a bonds that people want to purchase, they want to purchase the currencies. Even today, gold, I want to tell you the concept, the gold, the buying the physical gold, not safe, it is also, it is a highly risky, but buying the physical gold, we are paying extra money than the gold value in the form of making charges, stages, and especially in the GST also. But if the people want to buy the gold, e-gold, there is a mutual fund up there, exchange trade fund, we can call. They can buy units like one Nippon gold unit, gold piece. You just browse it, gold piece, you can able to know the value. So for example, monthly 500 rupees, I want to invest into the gold. I can't buy a physical gold for 500 rupees, but I can buy an e-gold, like exchange trade funds. Okay, Nippon gold piece. That is one example I am telling you. Like that, whatever I want to hold, these kind of electronic certificate, maybe shares or maybe gold or maybe bonds, that time DMAT account help for me. Trading.
Okay, everyone, meanwhile, submit the feedback link which is being sent in the chat box. Everyone, submit the feedback form. The link is shared in the chat box. So we have another question, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
From Akhilesh Hampli. Which is the safest form of investment?
Yes. It is free to open, or some amount is required for opening DMAT. Yes. You might notice that 5paisa.com and all, they are freely opening that account. Yes, see, everywhere now, you know that everywhere there are the things are happening, okay, but how we should be aware, that is the main thing. Open the DMAT account at the free of cost. That is not mean to say it is not a shape. It is a safe also. It's based upon the brokers. They are opening three in one account. They are opening freely also and giving to them. It's not mean that it is not safe. How you have to safely holding the DMAT account means, if you are anything you are doing in DMAT's account, that means buying and selling, that should be updated to you. Suppose any, the many of the persons, they will buy the shares, they won't do any trading in their demat account, means they have to freeze it for next 1 year. They have the plan, means they are not doing anything their demat account. They can able to freeze and keep it. So nobody in the position to trade in your demat account, use in your demat account for any other purpose. So like that, some precautionary mechanism or some of the guideline as a investor we have to follow. That is the way of having the safe. Where we are opening that, whether the free of cost we are opening the demat account, for paying high cost we are opening the demat account, that is not a matter. So what are the simple procedure we have to make in our demat account, make our demat account is very safe. That is my way of addressing that question. That's all the transaction whatever done in the demat account, that to be in that means with the knowledge of yours, without that is what you are handling the safely. What is mean by peer and pull and stock exchange? Yes sir, another question.
We have another question from Atish Kumar. What is product type? I have seen delivery, intraday and margin engine broking.
Margin, you are want to speak about
Kartika
margin.
Madam?
Yes sir, it's based upon it's a differ sir, he has to go for equity, that is differ, currency that is differ, derivative segment that intra, that it will be differ. So if you, first of all, as a students community, I don't suggest for do intraday. It's a highly risky. Okay, it's better be an investor, don't be a like intradayer or the speculator. Okay, it is how you might win few days, not all the days in the month. Okay, if you want to check me, GST, one is the transaction charge, GST 18%, all will be there. You just check with your brokers. It's not similar to all the broking. You are especially asking about angel broking, that you have to check with the Angel Broking Limited only. So based upon the shared broker, okay, the they are delivery charges and the margin also, it's a differ. Better checking with the particular where you have demat account, that is the best sir. But don't be behind the intra trading. It's a highly risk. That is my suggestion. I think hope okay. It is a 20 for another for intraday. I'm not going in depth on charges. It is 20, I think so, for intraday it is. For order wise they will charge.
Validity of IOC. There's another question from Atish Kumar.
Validity of IOC. In he's, I think he's wanting only angel broking validity of IOC. IOC, his type of order he want to take. Better he will interact with me, sir.
So thank you to all the participants for being active in the Q&A session. So let me start with the. It is my immense pleasure to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I pay my pranamas to Lord Shambhasveshwara, remembering the Lord late Pooja Dada Papaji, by touching the feet of Pooja Dr. Shambhasveshwara Papaji and Dr. Matoshri Awaji. And my sincere Kartika, taking us through the investment plans with reference to the Mediclaim policies, Atal Pension Yojana, National Pension Scheme, Fixed Invest, Fixed Income Investment and Mutual Fund. And we are very thankful for you, madam, for sharing your knowledge in finance sector, specifically in the investment. Once again, we thank P. Kartika ma'am, Professor of the Coordinating Department B. Mysuru, for your vast experience in the finance sector. My sincere thanks to all officers of Shambhasa University for the support. I would also thank Dr. S. H. Chanali, Dean of Faculty of Business Studies, Shambhasa University, for guiding us. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Vanishtri C. T., Chairperson,
Department of Tourism and Travel, Shanbasa University, for making this event successful. And I would also thank Dr. Santosh Bennur, Chairperson, Department of BPA, for supporting us. Last but not least, my sincere thanks to all my dear students, all my colleagues of Shanbasa University who joined us for the webinar. Thank you once again. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everyone, for your participation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And also, I want to thank all the faculty coordinators and the chairpersons of the Shanbasa University to today giving me the opportunity and interacting with the Chai's, such a wonderful students. And also I want to thank to all the participants of today's webinar. Thank you all once again.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Kindly submit the feedback form. The link is being provided in the chat box. Thank you all.